Hello everyone, thanks for watching this video. And today I am going to explain how to sort an integer array. You will be having one input array which is integer type, it will called 19824729. Assume that this is your input, so you need to sort into this order. So this is your expected output. Okay, so we will be having one main program. Okay, where we having this array as a input, integer type input array. Okay, so we need to write one API which will help us to sort this given input array which is provided by the user. Okay, public static void get sorted array. Okay, perfectly fine. We need to call this API dot get sorted array. We need to pass this array as a argument which is coming from users. Accordingly, we have to change the parameters for that. Okay, fine. Now let's have one local variable which hold your input data. Okay, input, fine. Now let's create one for loop which will help us to scan the array. As previous, our responsibility to check whether we are receiving the input correctly or not, which is provided by users. Let's run this program, run as Java application. Good, cool. So we are getting input correctly, which is provided by the users. Okay, now our target is to sort it. Okay, so for sorting, let's have another loop j equal to I plus 1. What I am doing is here basically one loop. I am just this loop which is able to scan that this input array which start from 0 to length minus 1. Okay, less than length. Second iteration, one again for loop, that I am starting from, I am just accepting this zeroth position, I am starting from I plus 1 to same length and j plus plus. Okay, fine. Just for your convenience, if you put your SOP here, okay, you have to put the input of j. Just see how the output will be. Okay, so for your understanding, this is I means your first array and this is your second loop. This is first loop, this is second loop, both are pointing to the same array. This loop which is I is to start from 0 and this start from I plus 1 means first position. If you run this program, see how the output will come. So basically for this one, you are scanning all this from 9 to 8. If you see, your input is 9 to 8. See, for one you are getting 1 from first loop and that loop you are start scanning till 29, accepting 1. You don't have 1 here. Okay, same like that. If you have 9, right, you are start scanning it and you are leaving 1 and 9. We are start scanning from 8. Fine. So that's why we kept this array. Later you can understand more also. Let's have one if flag. What basically it will tell is if zip I is greater than j. Okay, let's have greater than for now. So what you have to do is int temp equal to I. If the data from the first array is greater than data from the second array, let's create one temporary variable where you have to assign the first array data, and then first array data you need to replace with the second array data. Okay, and second array data you need to replace with temp. Okay, fine. So what you do is, now this is your input array, right? Don't just comment this for loop for now, and this input array is now got sorted. Okay, so for convenience we need to check whether it's really got sorted or not, and this loop is ending here. So after this loop we are assuming that the sorting happened properly. Okay, okay, fine. Input array of I, since we are storing that, we are sorting the input array, we don't have any extra array, so whatever operation we are doing into this same array, so that's the reason we are printing this array. Just do some formatting for user understandability. Run Java program, see how it's happening is 1 is less than 2, 2 is less than 4, 4 is less than 7, 7 is less than 8, 8 is less than 9, and 9 is less than 29. One more thing here, this is greater than. Now if you put less than, okay, see how the, so first you will get the first 9 8, so you can change your ascending order sorting and descending order sorting just to change 1 greater than or less than. Okay, see, let me summarize you. Okay, first as per hour we have the void, now we got the output and we want to return this as an integer array. Okay, since we had it as an integer array, so we must add one return type, and we don't need this for loop here. Okay, now we need to go exactly here. So here what I am trying to do, limit. So I am just, since this array get sorted array is returning array type. Okay, SHORTED sorted a double array. Okay, right, now let's print this sorted array. Since this is your only output, sorted array dot I, and just, okay, let's run this one now, then you understand why I'm hiding format. If you see like that, it's coming, it's not good, right? Not understandable. So let's add one empty string which will help you to manage the space. Okay, printl, I don't need the new line, everything should be printed into the single line. Now it's perfectly fine. Okay, so what we did is we got the array, we created two loops, one from 0 and one from 1, means ith plus 1, and both the element I start comparing, and with these things we start shuffling the element. So at the end we got the shuffled element, means we got the sorted element. Okay, thanks for watching this video.